EZID Mineral Identification Program has added an optional GeoSpec library and scalar functionality. EZID is part of Spectral Evolution's Darwin SP data acquisition software. Once connected to a spectrometer, begin by taking a reference scan. Turn on the external trigger of the attached contact probe, then select EZID Match Analysis from Darwin's menu. Scan a target sample with the contact probe. EZID includes the USGS library for pattern matching against known samples. The USGS library includes the JPL library for a total of 470 spectra for 314 minerals. In addition, there are two optional libraries, the SpecMin library and the GeoSpec library. SpecMin has 1,528 spectra for 494 minerals. The GeoSpec library has 688 spectra for 239 minerals. The minerals were from the Colorado School of Mines Museum collection, and scans were taken with the ultra-high-resolution SR6500 spectroradiometer. This is a scan of kaolinite, a clay. The samples of kaolinite from the different libraries are slightly different locations, but all have the same basic chemical composition. To provide additional understanding of your samples, EZID has added scalars. Scalars can enhance the geologist's understanding of crystallinity changes, alteration pattern shifts, and geochemical conditions at formation. The ALOH scalar measures the wavelength position near 2200 nanometers of the ALOH absorption feature to provide geochemical information at the time of the alteration event. The KX scalar is an indication of kaolinite crystallinity, which is strongly influenced by the temperature of fluids at the time of formation. This crystallinity influences the shape of the ALOH feature at 2200 nanometers. The KX scalar with a value of greater than 1 indicates a kaolinite produced by weathering. Less than 1 is generally associated with kaolinite produced by higher temperature alteration events. The Illite Maturity Scalar, ISM, indicates a loss of molecular water with an increase of crystallinity. ISM scalar values greater than 1 indicate a low metamorphic grade illite. Values less than 1 are generally associated with illite produced by a higher temperature. The Chlorite Spectral Maturity, CSM, scalar indicates loss of molecular water, increased depth of the ALOH feature near 2350 nanometers, and depth of the FEOH feature near 2260 nanometers. Values greater than 1 indicate low metamorphic grade chlorite. Values less than 1 indicate a high alteration temperature. MGOH scalar tracks the wavelength shift of the MGOH absorption feature near 2350 nanometers as an indicator of geochemical conditions at alteration. The FEOH scalar uses the wavelength shift of the absorption feature at 2260 nanometers as an indication of geochemical conditions at alteration. The FE3 scalar measures FE3 minerals, commonly girthite and hematite, which have a feature in the 750 to 1000 nanometer region. A value greater than 900 nanometers indicates the hydroxide type of FE3. A position less than 900 nanometers indicates the oxide type of FE3. The FE3I scalar uses the absorption feature for FE3 minerals like girthite and hematite with a strong absorption feature below 550 nanometers. The more intense the feature, depth and broadness, the more abundance of FE3 minerals. The ALFEMG scalar reports the wavelength of the deepest absorption feature of these three minerals between 2160 and 2370 nanometers and gives an indication of geochemical conditions at alteration. Scalar values for different minerals can provide a more complete picture of alteration patterns and lithology. For more information, visit www.spectralevolution.com.